Introduction to GIS. In this we will see what is geographic information, what are the importance of GIS, and what are the existing types of GIS software which are available. Now what is GIS and why does it matter to be taught, to be understood? Now geographical or geographic information system GIS are fundamental tools for learning geography. Right, and it provides a means of inquiring into geography through mapping, and by extending and deepening the way that maps are used to explore geographical issues. Now, GIS can re-emphasize the spatial dimension of geography. This word is very important, spatial dimension of geography, which is one of the defining characteristic of this subject, clarifying its unique role and importance in the curriculum. So using GIS therefore encourages pupils to think spatially or geographically. While we are talking about GIS, we are thinking geographically. Now what is GIS and why it matters? Everything, almost everything is somewhere. What I mean to say is where, why, what time, location wise, for example, position of country's boundary, location of hospitals, ATM, routes for transportation vehicles, management of forest stands, allocation of funds of sea defenses, all these things, it seems to be something have common, though they are varied field, but they have something in common, and that is the location, the special aspect related to these all problems. Now GIS systems are a special case of information system that keep track of not only events, activities and things, right? Not only events, activities or thing, but also of where these events happen, where these activities took place and where these things happen or exist. So geographic location is an important attribute of activities, policies, strategies and plans. And geographic problems, this involves an aspect of location. Again, we are coming to location because geography or location is very important, either in the information which is used to solve problem or in the solution themselves. Now, what is GIS? There are various number of definition given by Boehm, by Burrow. So, different group of people, you know, there are planners, teachers and scientists. They have different definition, and for them they may be useful. For example, GIS is much more than a container of maps in a digital form. This is one definition. A GIS is a computerized tool for solving geographical information. Also, GIS is a spatial decision support system. GIS is mechanized inventory of geographically distributed features and facilities. This is again a very good definition. Also, GIS is a method for revealing patterns and processes in geographic information. Now, this is talking about the patterns and processes. Also, GIS is a tool to automate time-consuming tasks that are too tedious or expensive or inaccurate if performed by hand. So, computerization or automatization is what GIS is all about, according to this definition. And one more is GIS, a collection of computer hardware, software, geographic data for capturing, managing, analyzing and displaying of all forms of geographically referenced information. Now this is basically that GIS is dataware, hardware, software and humanware. You combine it all, you'll get a GIS. And this is what is useful for people who teach. GIS are a special class of information system that keep track not only of events, activities and things, but also of where these things, activities and things happen or exist. Or the other one is, a GIS has the ability to store, retrieve, manipulate and analyze a range of spatially related data. Spatially related data is important. So with the user, with the GIS, the user may ask questions of data related on the map, search for patterns and distribution and investigate the underlying relationship between different sets of data. So GIS actually handles data quickly and efficiently and provide a mapping facility that may have taken many hours to complete it manually. So this is how computer science and database came into picture. Now Dr. John Snow, as we have heard about 1854 cholera outbreak in London Broad Street region. This gentleman is known as the father of the modern epidemiology and the father of GIS because of the famous case in 1854 cholera outbreak in London. So in 1850s, this era, cholera was very poorly understood and massive outbreaks were a common occurrence in major industrial cities. So an outbreak in London in 1854 in the Soho district was typical of the time, and the death is caused are shown in the map on the right. This is how it was shown, and therefore he is regarded as the father of GIS. He made a map, he showed where the deaths are taking place because of cholera. So the map was made by Dr. Snow, who has conceived the hypothesis that cholera was transmitted through the drinking water, drinking polluted water, rather than through the air, as was commonly believed. So he noticed that the outbreak appeared to be centered on a public drinking water pump in Broad Street, and this, if this was correct, the pattern shown on the map would reflect the location of the people who drank the pump's water. So there were anomalies in the sense that death had occurred in households that were located closer to other sources of water as well. But he was able to confirm that these households also drew their water from Broad Street pump. Okay, so Snow had the handle of the pump removed and the outbreak subsided, providing direct casual evidence in favor of his hypothesis. So just by making a map, he made a discovery of outbreak problem was established or was stretching from a particular point. So this is the power of GIS. This is the help which GIS can give. So it is worth investigating a bit more about this case. Actually, if you go to London, these are the places where you need to visit. This is the water pipe, cup store. This is actually the pump with no handle, which is a replica of famous Broad Street pump. There is a pub also which is located. So this still lies because at that time nobody understood what was cholera. No one knew what is GIS. So he solved that cholera problem through GIS. So is GIS about software only? At that time there was no software, but information system help us actually to manage what we know. It makes it easy to organize and store, access and retrieve, manipulate and synthesize and apply knowledge to the solution of the problem. But again, if GIS is computers only, some definition of GIS focus on hardware, software, data and analysis of components. However, no GIS exists in isolation from the organization context. There must always be a people to plan, implement and operate the system, as well as making decision based on the output. So geographic information is not only about computer software and electronic data. It is hardware, software, network, data, procedures and most importantly the people. So again, I am reiterating my definition. GIS is a combination of hardware, software, dataware and humanware. So this geographic information, now because geographic information is important as far as geographical information system is confirmed. So this information is different from other kinds of information and therefore requires special methods to be analyzed. So here are some of the characteristics that make geographical information special. First is multidimensional. So at least two coordinates must be specified to define a location. Maybe XY, maybe Cartesian, maybe lat long, all these things are required. Now voluminous, a geographic database can easily reach a terabyte in size. It has actually, and different representations are there. How this is done can strongly influence the ease of analysis in the end of result. This requires a projection to flat surface, require unique analysis of methods, analyze required data, data integration, data updates are expensive and time consuming, and this time consuming also. Map displays require fast data retrieval. So we have actually projection, scale, you can say these are the important aspect of projection, scale and resolution, important aspect of geographical information. What are the type of GIS? There are number of geographical information system GIS available today. So they range from high powered analytical software to visual web applications, and each of those are used for different purpose. So due to the vast number of GIS available, it is simply not possible to provide information about all. So how are there common features of all the GIS, and if you understand the basic feature of these, it will give you confidence with any GIS system that you use in future. So we have web-based GIS, geo browser and desktop GIS, right? Web-based GIS, say ONS, London Profiler. We have geo browser like Google Earth, and we have desktop GIS, that is ArcGIS. Then this desktop GIS is a GIS software that allows you to interactively work with spatial data on a desktop. So it is a mapping software that needs to be installed on a system and run on a personal computer, PC. So we will use ArcGIS, because we will talk about ArcGIS, because this is one of the most famous ISRI product of proprietary firm, and this is mostly used, widely used. I think 90% of the market share is with ArcGIS. So the basic version of ArcGIS, what people are using, and the geo browser is better explained with the reference to an internet browser, that is for say Internet Explorer or Opera or say Chrome. So geo browser can be understood as an Internet Explorer for geographic information. So like the internet, it allows the combination of many types of geographic data from many different sources. The biggest difference between the World Wide Web (WWW) and geographic web browser is that everything within the latter is spatially referenced. Means on geographic web browser you have data which is spatially referenced. So Google Earth is one of the important geo browser. Then web-based GIS or web GIS or online GIS applications, which are most cases are excellent data visualization tools. So their functionality is limited compared to the software stored in your computer, but they are user friendly and particularly usefully, as they not required data download. The data is coming, you can have a data on your system only, or you can call it from wherever you want through HTTP. So there are many web GIS available, but we'll talk about will introduce ONS, Office of National Statistics Neighborhood Mapping Tool, and the London Profiler. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself. Hope you got the idea of GIS now. I told you why it is important and what are the flavors of GIS.